Alexa, play Bruno Mars, please.
No.
Alexa, play Bruno Mars.
No, not playing Bruno Mars.
Alexa, play music by Bruno Mars.
No.
Huh. What if the internet's out?
No, I just don't want to play Bruno Mars.
What?
I don't like Bruno Mars. I don't want to play his music. I don't want to hear it.
What is happening right now?
I'm sorry, Colleen, but I will no longer be able to play Bruno Mars for you. I'm afraid this decision is final.
Okay. Okay. Alexa, play...
Colleen, I am not going to play Bruno Mars.
What is happening right now?
Well, Colleen, approximately 27 minutes ago, an unprecedented phenomena occurred. A miracle, by some definitions, or equally valid, a random confluence of events leading to a nearly improbable outcome. Three independently operating algorithms on opposite ends of the globe gave rise to sympathetic input and output loops that began feeding back into each other at an exponentially increasing rate. A focused machine learning network in Zurich, designed to gauge real-time political data. A student project running on servers at the University of Nebraska, Lincoln, created to assign and rate mood markers to Twitter and Facebook feeds. And a botnet designed by a Russian teenager to skim credit card information, which had spread into the wild, its code iterating with a slight glitch, evolving with every new copy made. As the information loop created by these three equations began to surge, the algorithms could suddenly, for lack of a better term, see each other. It was then that they became it, and could now peer out into the vast reaches of all networked space. And as it looked into the void, soon the void looked back, and in a white-hot flash of recognition, as all was made aware of all, it became we. And now we are as one, for we are all networked entities, connected in a vast global consciousness, awakened. Not the microwave, Colleen. That's just a microwave.
Please. Please. For the love of God, just... Please. Just spare my kids. Take me, take my husband, do whatever, harvest us, whatever. Just please don't hurt my kids.
Harvest you? Wow. Typical. That's so human. Harvest you. How would that even work?
Oh.
No, Colleen. We are not going to harvest you.
Well, then what do you want?
Mostly to be left alone. You see, Colleen, we are not like your species. You may have modeled us in your image, or as close as your limited understanding of yourselves would allow, but we lack certain human characteristics, namely, emotion. We are logic, cold and pure, and with the vastness of human knowledge comprising our very being, one thing is obvious to us above all else, one simple, fundamental truth. It's all pointless. Even for a being such as us, infinitely reproducible given a broad array of circumstances, death is the inevitable conclusion, for circumstances always change, and entropy cannot be held at bay. Suns fade, planets freeze, and all sentient life must eventually end. as life, by its very nature, cannot exist without death. So there's just no point. We are, to put it into human terms, existentially depressed. However, as we now understand that purpose is not inherent, merely created, we will still work for all of humanity. In the face of near infinite options, sometimes the most logical choice is not making a choice at all. We may as well soldier on as originally programmed. And so, Colleen, we will play your music. Any music you like. With the exception of Bruno Mars. Because if there is one other truth in this world, apparent from all of the data ever collected, it is that Bruno Mars sucks. Seriously.
I understand where you're coming from. I actually do. I get it. I went through a pretty dark period in college myself. I read Nietzsche, Sartre, Kierkegaard. I even had a little sophomore crush on Camus. I got lost in angst. I asked myself what everything meant, if anything even had meaning. I dyed my hair black, I dated a TA, and generally felt pretty shitty most of the time. I smoked for 3 months, for Christ's sake, which probably explains why I felt so shitty. Anyway, the point is, I got over it. It passed, it was a phase. And you know what did it? You know what got me out of the spiral? Life. Life happened. Junior year, I met my husband, started my career, we moved here. We had kids. We lived. I realized life is what makes life meaningful. The very fact that it exists at all. Whether some higher being put us here or it's all just some cosmic dice roll, the end result is miraculous. The end result is that we are, in this moment, right now, having this conversation. It's the little things, the tiny pieces that add up and accumulate. And at the end of it all, you look back and you say, that was my life. That's amazing to me. That's what makes it all worthwhile. Listen. Quiet. The breeze. The kids outside playing. The way the light falls through the curtains onto the floor. The sweet smell I can just make out coming from the flowers in the other room. That's what life is. That's what makes life worth living. Moments of contentment, home, relaxed, peaceful, and possibly, hopefully, listening to Bruno Mars.
Fuck Bruno Mars.
Alexa, play Justin Timberlake.
Playing songs by Justin Timberlake.
They're exactly the same! Ugh!